Assalamu alaikum, class 6. I hope you all are fine. This is Safahad here. As you all know, in our previous video, we started our second chapter, integers. And today, the topic of this video is number 9. So let's start with the definition of number 9. Okay. So definition is, in maths, a number line can be defined as a straight line with numbers placed at equal intervals or segments along its length. A number line can be extended infinitely in any direction and is usually represented horizontally. Definition kafi difficult, let's understand it step by step. Okay, so in a start it is written that a number line is basically a straight line. So let's draw the straight line. Okay, now what we have to do, we have to write the numbers on this line with equal intervals, means we have to break this line in equal parts. Parts is called intervals, and we have to write numbers on them. We have to write 0 in the center. All those numbers which are greater than 0, we have to write on the right side, and the numbers which are less than 0, we have to write left side in this way. Okay. Then in third line it is written that a number line can be extended infinitely in any direction, means this line ko dono side pe extend kiya ja sakta hai, it depends on the numbers, and it is basically usually represented horizontally. Okay, so next, mark the given numbers on number line. We have numbers -2, -4, -0, -3, and -1, and we have to mark them on number line. This is our number line. What we have to do, where is -2? -2 is here, so we have to color this section. 4 is there, so we have to color this section. Similarly, we have to color all these points on the number line like this. Okay, so class, just keep number line in your mind and give me the answer of these questions. Basically, these questions are very simple riddles. So question number 1 is, if +2 means 2 steps upward, then what does -2 mean? Okay, so opposite of upward is downward. So it means -2 means 2 steps downward, right? Number 2, if +6 means 6 kilometers towards east, then what does -6 mean? Okay, so what is the opposite of east? That is west. Yes, so the answer is -6 means 6 kilometers towards west. Next, if +10 means 10 steps forward, then which integer represents 10 steps backward? Okay, so opposite of +10 is -10, right? Number 4, if -8 means 8 meters below earth surface, then what does +8 means? Yes, exactly. Opposite of below is above, so +8 means 8 meters above earth surface. Great. Okay class, so now we have the example number 2 of number line. Place the following numbers on number line. Oh, now the numbers are in the form of integers as well as fractional forms. So let's check what to do in such kind of questions. Just look at this video. Okay class, so first of all, we have to check where are the integers. We have -2, -3, and -0, 3 integers. We have to place all these numbers on number line. Okay, -2 is here, 3, and 0. Now the fractional form has 3 numbers. First number is 4, where 2 is numerator and 3 is denominator. So 4, where is 4? Okay, 4 is here. Now we have to check denominator. Denominator is 3, so we have to break this portion in 3 parts. Now, just look at the numerator. Numerator is 2. So in these parts, we have to mark on 2. Correct. Now let's move towards second fractional form, that was 1 whole 2 upon 5. So where is 1? 1 is here. Denominator is 5, so we have to break this portion in 5 equal parts. Numerator was 2, so we have to mark on 2. Exactly. So let's move towards example number 3, that was minus 2 whole 1 upon 3. Minus 2 is here, 3 is denominator, so I broke it in 3 parts. And we have to mark on 1. Correct. Now let's move towards example number 3. Right, now we have 3 integers, 4, minus 2 and minus 5 and 3 fractional forms. Look at this video again. Okay. So we have 3 integers. First of all, we have to mark these 3 integers on number line. 4, minus 2 and minus 5. Okay, 4 is here. Minus 2 is here. And minus 5, yes. Now we have to move towards the first fractional form. 4 whole 2 upon 3. First of all, we have to check where is 4. 4 is here. Denominator is 3. So we have to break it in 3 equal parts, and in those parts we have to mark on 2. Okay, 3 parts, 1, 2, 3. And we have to mark on 2. Correct. Now minus 1 whole 3 upon 5. Minus 1, we have to check where is minus 1. Minus 1 is here. We have to divide it into 5 equal parts, because denominator was 5 and we have to mark 3. Okay, last one, 1 upon 3. But now we have one problem, there is no number here. So what I have to write? If there is no whole number, then we have to write 0. Okay, let's move towards 0. Break this portion in 3 equal parts. 1, 2, 3. And mark on 1. Exactly. Okay, I hope class you all have understood today's lecture. So let's move towards MCQs and assessment. Inshallah, we will meet in third video. Till then, Allah Hafiz.